Hello guys, me Charles Edison, Capricorn of Earth, and welcome to another edition of F1 2022 Grand Prix. So, here we are in the Australian Grand Prix race weekend. So, as you saw in the last video of this series, Saudi Arabia was awful, and Jeddah, man, with low upgrades, I just couldn't do much, you know, and I just DNF'd. Right after I pitted, and then boom, up in smoke. But I didn't like edit the video or proofread or looked at the video closely and made sure I knew what I was doing before doing the Australian Grand Prix. So for this Albert Park track, they renovated a few things, I'm not an F1 expert, but they wanted the more straightaway speed. I'm sorry, this is going to be my video clip. But anyways, they just want to get rid of those tight turns, you know, like, pretty professional drivers like missing the corner and getting in the grass, you know, like, remember Fernando Alonso's F1 crash here in Australia? I mean, he tried to pass and he tumbled over. So that's probably the reason why they wanted to change that corner in Australia. So yeah, that's probably the only F1 crash I've seen in Australia where it was really severe and it paid some repercussions in Alonso's career, you know, and he's an Alpine driver in F1 right now, and yeah. I know I want to watch F1, but 8 o'clock is a little bit too early for me to watch F1 race, but who knows, maybe someday I'll watch and see how it'll work out. So I'm a Capricorn of Earth, you all have a great day, peace out.
Natalie Pinkham joins me one.
Start was okay, now stay alert for threats around you. Good job from you and the crew there, mate. We're satisfied with that. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Use your overtake button for more power. We need to push. And gap to the car in front is 40.7 seconds. Magnussen stopping now. Thank you. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 26.4 seconds. Blue flag. Okay, we think the underbody's incurred some slight damage, but nothing too serious at the moment, just be careful. Right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
A great race then, and a fantastic victory. And here we are, a team that is... Let's have a quick look at how the driver's standings have changed. Charles Leclerc assumes the lead in the standings after today's outstanding result. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Often, my go-to would be a driver who's managed to pull off an especially impressive feat during the race.
So we're coming to the end of my YouTube video right now, so give a thumbs up button if you like the video so much. Click on that bell button to subscribe for more content, and if you saw the recent video interesting, share the comment right below the description so you can share some thoughts and feelings with everybody in the community and make them feel welcome. So I make a happy Corona 95. You all have a great day and peace out.